is a life-changing message by the Reverend Sam Crunchy Ankara.
Somebody say, ready for change. Oh, I didn't hear you. Somebody say, ready for change. That is the theme for the youth this year. A change cannot happen unless, number one, the one who desires the change sees what God sees. So, number one, you need to agree with God where He is taking you, what He wants to do in your life. I believe that God wants to hand over an inheritance. I believe that God wants to make you a leader in your generation. I believe that God wants to give you a different story from other brothers and sisters and aunties and uncles and fathers and mothers in your family. I believe that God wants to cut a path different from where everybody else walked. My father married plenty of women. I have married one woman for 30 years. It's Jesus, because I chose a different path. My father's 22 children. All of them went to marry. The women, they all went. 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. The men, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5. I have broken myself from that curse of divorce. My marriage this September will be 30 solid years. It's possible to walk a different path from others. It depends on your mind, your attitude, what you see. See what God says. Have God's mind. Agree with what God says He knows and says about you. He said to Gideon, I see you a mighty man of valor. I see you defeating the Midianites as one man. He said, me? I belong to the least of the families of Israel. God said, notwithstanding, you will defeat them. How do you see yourself? One sermon will not make you see yourself. That is why you need to associate with us in WMG. Because every day you hear somebody's testimony, every day you hear a word that brings out the who in you. And once you line up and you see what God sees about you, you are ready to take new territories. My sons and my daughters, clap your hands and say, I'm ready for change. Ready for change. Ready for change. Here is the second thing. Number one, you see what God sees. Number one, you accept who God says you are. Number two. And then the last one. Number three. Yeah. See what God sees. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12. God came to Jeremiah and said, what seest thou? He said, I see an almond tree. He said, very well, you have seen enough. Based upon what you see, there shall be a performance. When God wanted to bless Abraham, He said to Abraham, lift up your eyes and see the land in front of you. Look at the one. See. Once you see and you agree with me, walk through the land and it shall become your possession. And indeed, what Abraham saw and walked through became his possession. God can never start a journey with you if you don't see what He sees. You can never. Number two, you have to accept what God says you are. He says, you are my son, you are my daughter, that's who you are. It doesn't matter what you go through. It doesn't matter what others say. And I love the song. The song says, I don't care, I don't listen to what people say about me, and I refuse to be bound. If they didn't create you, how dare them tell you who they think you are? You are not what they say you are. You are who God says you are. Here is the third thing. The third thing, if you want a change, is that your desire must conform to His will. Your desire must conform to His will. Why are you praying for what you are praying for? What for? What do you want that thing for? For your glory or for His glory? If I were talking to a politician, I would ask a politician, why do you want to become president of Ghana? Why do you want me to vote for you? Give me one reason. If I was talking to a group of people who want to become pastors, I would ask them, why do you want to become a pastor? Is it because you see me driving SUV? Your desires must conform. And here was one guy who was ready for a change. His name is Bartimaeus. Jesus Christ was passing and people were shouting. Heta sketa. He was blind. He couldn't see. And then he said, what is that? What is happening? They said, Jesus Christ is passing. Then he said, Jesus, this must be the seed of David. this must be the Jesus who was prophesied. So he started screaming, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy upon me, Jesus. And then Jesus heard him and he said, call him. And then Jesus asked him, so what do you want me to do for you? What desire do you have? Does it conform to my will for you? I want you to know that Bartimaeus could have presented five things, possible things. Number one, he could have said, Jesus, they've taken my house from me since I became blind. Restore my house. Request number one. Number two, Jesus, my beautiful wife has forsaken me and taken all my children away. Lord, I wanted to go and bring my wife. Request number two. Request number three. He could say, Jesus, today the market has been very dry. The people who are passing are not giving money at all. Jesus, cause them. Tomorrow when I come, they must give me money. Request number three. Request number four. Jesus, the people who bring me here every morning, these days, when I'm calling them, I don't see them. Equia, Equia in Spanish. Yeah, where are you? They are tired. Lord, Jesus, touch their hearts so that every morning they'll be ready to bring me. Request number four. And then request number five. I want my eyes to open. Which of these five conforms to God's will? You have to get it right. If you don't get it right, the miracle does not happen. I pray that your prayers will be right before God. It will conform to the will of God for your life so that God can give you 24-hour miracle, 48-hour response, 3-day response to your prayers. If you are the one I'm talking to, clap your hands and shout, I am the one. Ready for change. Ready for change. I believe this miracle. Give me Daniel chapter number 1 and verse number. Daniel chapter 1 and verse number 20. I'm believing God for this miracle. Daniel chapter 1 and verse number 20. Start from 19 if I have something there. Then the king interviewed them, all the students in the king's court. And among them, none was found like Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, the three boys normally called Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore, they served before the king. Verse number 20. And in all matters of wisdom and understanding, about which the king examined them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and the astrologers who were in all his realm. So I wanted to know that you will not be the first person to be writing exams. And that in the days of Daniel, they were in the college of the king. And the Bible says they were studying matters of wisdom and matters of understanding. What will be the subject under matters of wisdom and understanding? They were studying philosophy. They were studying law. And they were studying some amount of administration. How to govern. In all of these, anytime they wrote the exams, they did better 10 times more. They were 10 times higher than their peers. That's the realm we are bringing you. We are bringing you to a place where your competitors will not match you. Clap your hands and say, I receive it. Oh, I didn't hear you say, I receive it. You see, the reason why you didn't respond, you are funny. Because at the moment, you are at the bottom of the class. So when I say you are going to be higher, you are looking at my face and say, you guy, you don't know. There was a guy in our class, Form 1, Form 2, Form 3, he was in the bottom. Form 4, we didn't know what happened. We all went to the science class. Shoom. Additional mass, 80. Mathematics, 90. Chemistry, physics. All level, he blew distinction. He's a doctor now. The guy was carrying the class on the bottom. I don't know what happened. So you better believe me when I say God is going to raise you 10 times higher than your peers. Clap your hands and say, I receive the oil. Tell somebody, all things are possible with God. Oh no, she didn't hear you. Tell her again, say, all things. Tell somebody, my sister, we serve a mighty God, Ankasa. Tell, we serve a powerful God. Chapter 2 of Daniel. Chapter 2 of Daniel, I think verse number, the last three verses. Daniel 2, the last three. I will do this in NIV. Chapter 2 and verse 47. Now, Daniel's wisdom had been called to play again. The king had a dream which must be interpreted. No wise man in the land could interpret. So the king got angry and ordered that all the wise men, for not being able to interpret this dream, they should be all caught and killed. And Daniel was going to die because he was one of them. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, they were some of the wise people. So Daniel called the man and said, why does the king is being harsh. Ask the king to give me some few days. After some few days, Daniel went to the king. He said, king, I'm ready to deliver to you wisdom. And Daniel was, oh, Jesus Christ. When we talk about interpretation of dream, it's amazing. But I discovered on this occasion that Daniel was not only interpreting dream, but Daniel, because he was a philosopher and he was a lawyer, he was able to combine politics, and he gave the king some vivid description of what will be happening to his kingdom, the invasion of other kingdoms that will come in, 1, 2, 3, 4 kingdoms, Jesus Christ, please go to school for me, I beg you. If you stop school, I charge you to go back to school. Because if you don't go to school, you can never rule, you can never take authority, you can never do the things that God wants you to do. In those days, if you are not intelligent, they will ask you to go and do hairdressing. They will ask you to go and do makeuping. They will ask you to go and do sewing. Mama Rita's makeup artist has a master's degree from University of Ghana. Master's. She's hot. You are looking for her weekend, you can't find her. She's in Kumasi, she's in Takrade, she's here, she's there, making big money. Those who didn't go to school, go and find out whether they are doing any makeuping. Go and find out anybody who didn't go to school who is doing hairdressing. And I got some hairdressing, that's what they do. Tell somebody to go to school. Tell somebody to go to school. Go to school. Hairdressing and makeuping and dressmaking, and it's not for failures anymore. Now university graduates have entered in it. They have changed the landscape. If you are here, renew your mind and change your mind. Somebody say ready for change. I didn't hear somebody say ready for change. Now there are some graduates in this church who have started making inkatia cake. They've started making pancake chips. And if you see the way they package it, I know that they are going somewhere. Very soon, their inkatia cake will be served on aeroplanes. Oh, are you clapping or you are doing something like... Tell somebody there's work in Ghana. Tell somebody there's work. There's work in Ghana. Tell somebody there's work in Ghana. Stop this laziness and say there's no work. You just need wisdom from God. Somebody say ready for change. Oh, I didn't hear you. Somebody say ready for change. Daniel gave a powerful exposition. Now see what happened. NIV. Then the king said to Daniel, surely your God is the God of gods and the Lord of kings, and a revealer of mysteries, for you were able to reveal this mystery. Verse 48. Then the king placed Daniel in a high position and lavished him with many gifts, He made him ruler over the entire province of Babylon and placed him in charge of all its wise men. You are going to school, and when you finish school, you will step at the top and you'll be the head at the place. That is your target and that is your vision. The reason why I am pastoring you is to pump wisdom into you. Then King Nebuchadnezzar fell prostrate before Daniel and paid him honor and ordered that an offering and incense be presented to him. When you finish school, may kids bow before you because of your wisdom. Do we have a first lady of Ghana? Does she wear clothes? Is it not a human being who sews for her? May you be the same sense of a first lady tomorrow. It's equivalent to bowing. Because she can call her. Seamstress, I said, is my clothes ready? And then the sister said, oh no, mommy, this week I was very busy. I was doing things for wedding people and so on. And then I can hear the first lady began, oh, why do you do that? I need this dress. Remember, she's been sewing for her in the last 8 years, 10 years. So you can't break relationship. Because she's the only person who sews and fits you. And the king fell prostrate and said, give Daniel gifts. Because of the store of wisdom. Oh, see, I'm prophesying what will happen to you in 7 years. So don't joke with it. You may be in SSS. But I say, when you finish university, may you get the best employment ever. And may your boss love you. And may your boss shower gifts unto you. Clap your hands and shout, I receive this wisdom. 48. Then the king placed Daniel in high position and lavished many gifts on him. He made him the ruler over the entire province of the Babylon and placed him in charge of all its wise men. 49. Moreover, at Daniel's request, the king appointed Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego administrators over the province of Babylon, while Daniel himself remained at the royal court. If you are not powerful, you cannot recommend somebody to be employed. May the Lord make you powerful. And may you become so vital in your company and your house that any recommendation you give, they will listen to you. You can employ your brothers and your sisters and they will have to, oh, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Clap your hands and say, I receive this grace. May you not become ordinary like ordinary people. May you become extraordinary because of the extraordinary spirit. If I were you, I would clap my hands and say, I receive it. I built my first house at age 40. I wanted to break that record. You must build your first house at age 29. At age 30 and 32. Am I talking to some sons in the house? Clap your hands and shout, I receive it. And the king lifted Daniel and made him head and made him ruler because he was wise, because he had an excellent spirit, because he was intelligent, because he had educated himself. I pray that my sons will be wise. If you are here and your schooling is being challenged, refuse to stop where you have stopped. Tell yourself, like J.B. Dankwa, you will fail 7 times, but you rise up again 7 times. And finally you make it. Clap your hands and say, in the name of Jesus, I refuse to remain on the ground. I lift myself from the ground and I move myself forward. I will school myself. I will educate myself. I will marry. I will marry the right person and I will get a good job. I will create my own business. I will employ people. I will support the kingdom. I will support my family. I refuse to walk the way others walked. I refuse to be ordinary. Oh, I didn't hear you. I refuse to be ordinary. I didn't hear you. I refuse to be ordinary. Clap your hands and say, I will not be ordinary. I will not be ordinary. Something must happen. Clap your hands and say, I'm ready for church. Hey, pray this prayer. Yamihon Sanchirani. Hey, man, see me here. Clap your hands and pray. The altar is speaking. The altar is speaking. Come on, pray it again. Mighty man. Mighty man. Minister to me, my son. Give me a joyful noise in this house. Clap your hands and make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise. Lift up an incense before Jehovah. We bring our tears before God the King. May May the Lord place our future in His hands, and may the Lord make a path for us. A year today, 2 years, 10 years, we will never lose anybody in this place. But everybody will be fashioned according to the will and the counsel of God. That is my prayer. That is my desire. That's my wish for the sons and daughters here. That wherever you are and whatever you do and whatever your circumstances, may the light of God shine upon you. In the name of Jesus, I call it done. And the sons and daughters who believe, clap your hands and shout hallelujah. Clap your hands and shout hallelujah. Can you locate 7 people? Locate 7 people and say, brother, I am standing with you in your troubles. I'm standing with you in your pain. I'm standing with you in your tears. It shall be well. We shall celebrate together. We shall rejoice together. Come on, look for somebody and tell somebody, I'm standing with you.
And prayer that this message will have an effect on your life and will lift you to the place where you belong. For an additional copy of this and any other life-changing CDs, please look up the address on your CD: Royal House Chapel International, Touching Our Generation with the Power of God. God richly bless you.